Okay, good morning Zambia, good morning Africa, good morning the entire world. I will not waste much of your time today. I just want to speak my honest opinion about the coronavirus. It is very much shocking that we have a pandemic in the world that has got levels like a movie. It is very much shocking that we have got a pandemic in the world that has got levels like studying a degree program. It is so much shocking in the world that we have got a pandemic. Okay, that has got parts. We had the first wave of the coronavirus. Now we have got the second wave of the coronavirus. We have got the third wave of the coronavirus. Now we have been told by the architects, the people who are championing the COVID agenda, that we have got the fourth wave, which is called now the coronavirus Delta, the COVID Delta. Coronavirus, this is from my own opinion. This is from my own study, my own research. I want to say that coronavirus is a conspiracy. The people that are behind coronavirus, they want to wipe out the population of this world. The people that are behind coronavirus, they are interested in making profit. They are interested in wiping out the population of Africa and the world, especially poor people in Africa. The people who are behind coronavirus, they are interested in weakening economies of targeted countries. The people who are behind coronavirus, they are interested in making the world to be operating on Zoom, to be operating on the internet. They want to do away with the institutions where people have to go to school to go and sit in class and start learning. They want the world to be digital. They want to unite the world by making the world come together under one platform, the internet, on Facebook, on YouTube. They want people not to go to school. They want people to be sitting in Zoom meetings for them to be accessing lessons. They want people to sit on YouTube to be accessing lessons. They don't want people to meet anymore. They don't want people to go and shop physically on the market in shops. They want to create websites where you don't have to go outside to go and buy your goods. They want you to go on Amazon to go and shop on Amazon, thereby making money. Okay? They don't want the world to be meeting, families to meet, to visit people in villages, their grandchildren, their grandmothers in villages. They want us to be calling each other on video calls, WhatsApp video calls, so that WhatsApp, those who are handling and managing WhatsApp, they should be making more money. They want the world to be digital, to be on one platform. They don't want you and me to be having hard cash in terms of money. What they want is they want you and me to be using money in our phones. They want to achieve what is called a cashless society, where you don't handle money physically, but your money is moving in phones. You are wiring money to be electronic, money to be moving in electronic gadgets. That is what they are trying to achieve by bringing these deadly pandemics. Now, let me tell you the reason why coronavirus is not ending. The reason why coronavirus is not ending is very simple. The reason why coronavirus is not ending is because when they first gave the coronavirus, okay, when they first brought coronavirus before on the surface of the earth, they did not achieve their intended purpose. They did not achieve it. They did not achieve the mission of bringing one global world, unifying the whole world on the internet. So what they did was, because the mission was not accomplished, what they did was that they brought it again, which was called now the second wave. Okay? When they brought the second wave of coronavirus, they saw that the second wave of the coronavirus also did not achieve the mission. They brought it again in the second line, which was now the third wave of the coronavirus. When they brought the third wave of the coronavirus and they saw that the results were not attainable, they brought the third wave, the fourth wave. And now they have seen that they have not managed with the third wave of the coronavirus. They have now introduced the fourth wave of the coronavirus, which they are calling the COVID Delta. Now, the first wave, the second wave, and the third wave of the coronavirus was not very powerful in countries like, in continents like Africa, because of the hot temperature. Now they have created the COVID Delta. The COVID Delta is a type of coronavirus that is very much suitable in Africa, because we are told that the COVID Delta does not require, you know, the temperature to be cold for it to affect people. The COVID Delta is a kind of a coronavirus whereby even in hot temperatures, you are going to get this virus. It doesn't require you to be coughing, to show signs of coughing, signs of coldness. No. It directly affects the lungs, COVID Delta. It is specifically suitable. It is specifically tailored for African countries, even in the Sahara Desert. This so-called COVID Delta can affect you. They have created COVID Delta to specifically now wipe out the population of Africa. Why? Because in the US right now, there is a heat wave in the US. And the scientists world over, they are saying that the world right now is going to be more hotter than it was 100 years ago. So they have created a new COVID-19 called the COVID Delta that can survive in hot temperatures in order to wipe out the population of Africa. Africans, we must be very careful. This is a very great conspiracy. And this conspiracy, we must be very careful. We must be very serious about it. As Africans, we must denounce. We must denounce this virus, this conspiracy that scientists are bringing out before the face of this world. I've told you that the reason why they have brought all these pandemics is that they want to amass a lot of wealth at the expense of human lives. The people that are benefiting from this coronavirus fiasco, conspiracy, are tech companies like YouTube, those Amazon tech companies. They are benefiting from this coronavirus, because when we have been taught to stay home, we are meant to use Facebook, we are meant to use Amazon, we are meant to use Zoom, we are meant to use WhatsApp. These are the platforms that we are remained with. Those that are told not to go to school, they are meant to use Zoom to access classes, WhatsApp, YouTube, Facebook, for them to get the information, Google. The people that are running Google, the people that are running Zoom, the people that are running WhatsApp, the people that are running YouTube, Amazon, the people that are running Alibaba, and all these websites, online, you know, marketing websites, tech companies, are the ones that are benefiting from this coronavirus fiasco, this conspiracy. They are making billions and billions of US dollars at the expense of this virus. The second category of people that are benefiting from the coronavirus, they are pharmaceutical companies. I was told, and I did my research, that those that are making AstraZeneca and COVID-19 vaccines, they are the richest now in the whole entire world, and those that are running tech companies. Because one vaccine of AstraZeneca, it costs a lot of dollars. Just one vaccine, just one dose. And the people that are buying these vaccines, their countries, they are using national treasuries. They are using their treasury to buy these vaccines for their people in respective countries. So the people that are creating vaccines, they are making a lot of money. These people who are creating vaccines, they are making a lot of money. The people that are, the companies that are creating, that are manufacturing face masks, they are making billions of dollars. The companies that are making gloves, they are making billions of dollars. The companies that are making hand sanitizers, they are making billions of dollars. The companies that are making oxygen ventilators, the companies that are manufacturing oxygen ventilators, they are making billions of dollars. Okay? The companies that are making scanning machines, they are making billions of dollars. The companies that are making, you know, protective clothings in COVID centers, those masks, those protective clothings in isolation centers, they are making billions of US dollars. Okay? This is the greatest world conspiracy. The sooner that we as Africans realize that this vaccine has been created by men and women who are greedy, who are trying to reduce the population of the world, who are trying to make profit, okay? Who are trying to make profit at the expense of human lives, the better. Because the people that are benefiting from this conspiracy, they are technological companies, they are pharmaceutical companies, those that are producing COVID kits, face masks, oxygen ventilators, hand sanitizer, they are the ones, the people that are benefiting from this COVID crisis. They are tech companies that are running Zoom, WhatsApp, YouTube, and a number of things. Okay? They are trying to shift the attention of the world. They want to make the world come, you know, make a 90 degrees U-turn. Okay? If people used to report for work in the bank, they are trying to change the narrative. They want bankers not to report for work. They want bankers to be using their computer, to be using their emails, to be discussing on Zoom, on WhatsApp. They want documents to be sent online. They don't want people to go and line up at the bank. Those that are in the banking sector, they are also benefiting. Because what happens is that it reduces their labor. A bank will no longer employ 100, you know, people, cashiers. A bank will no longer employ a lot of people. Why? Because they will only need 5 people to be sending emails, to be receiving money or online. Okay? That is now we are entering into what is called a cashless society. Okay? We are entering into a cashless society. And this is also benefiting the banking sector. Those that are in the banking sector, they are also benefiting because a lot of companies, a lot of universities, Harvard University has reduced its workmanship as we are speaking now because the lecturers, they are home giving online classes. So there will be no need to employ a lot of people. The banks, there will be no need to employ a lot of people. This is the greatest world conspiracy that was arrived at by people in the banking sector, in the financial sector, technological companies, pharmaceutical companies. They sat and agreed they sat and agreed, okay, those the scientists who are behind manufacturing this virus in the lab, they are benefiting because when they create this virus, they are also creating an antivirus, like the way they create antiviruses. They create a virus in the computer and they create an antivirus. This is what they have done. They have created a COVID-19 and they have also created a cure. They have created, you know, a vaccine. The scientists are also benefiting. How long are we going to suffer as citizens of Africa? I want to tell you, Africa, Zambia, Uganda, Namibia, Botswana, Ghana, Egypt, and all, okay, South Africa, all countries, let's rise up and denounce these vaccines that they are giving us. Because some of these vaccines that they are giving us are contributing to the cases of COVID-19. Let us get back to our African remedy. We had swine flu, okay, that wiped out the population of the world. How were our grandmothers, how were our grandfathers curing themselves from dangerous diseases 100 years ago? It is high time that Africa got back to its basics. How do we get back to our basics? Let's discover home remedies, African solutions to these vaccines. And I want to tell you, Africa, that for as long as these white people, for as long as they have not achieved what they want, they have not made their profit, okay? They have not made their profit. For as long as these white people, they have not made their money, for as long as these white people, they have not achieved their agenda, we are going to even reach as far as the 10th wave of COVID-19. We are going to have the 10th wave of COVID-19. Remember, we started with the first wave, second wave. We are now at the fourth wave. And they are telling us that they have created what is called COVID Delta. Watch out for this COVID Delta. There is a COVID Delta, a new wave of COVID, which is now called the COVID Delta. And this COVID Delta is going to wipe out the population of Africa. Okay, because this COVID Delta is penetrating even amidst hot temperatures. It is specifically meant for African countries and those countries that have got hot temperatures. You don't need to show signs of coughing. You don't need to show signs like the way this third wave is. Okay, it directly affects the lungs. This is the reason why I'm giving out my founded research, my opinion about the COVID-19, and I'm trying to say that there is more to the COVID-19 than the issue of wearing face masks. There is more to the issue of COVID-19 than the issue of hand sanitizing. Okay? We have seen people who have been putting on face masks, hand sanitizing, but they ended up getting the COVID-19. There is more to the issue of coronavirus. Because look, the scientists, they told us, okay? The scientists, they told us that even when you do you put on face masks and you do hand sanitizing, you do all those things, you also are at the risk of contracting COVID-19. How can it be that even after taking AstraZeneca, okay, it is still not the cure, the 100% cure to COVID-19, okay? This pandemic is a conspiracy. We as Africans, we must speak out. If you want, you can also give your own opinion about the COVID-19. But for me, my opinion and my research is that this pandemic, it is a conspiracy that has been done by pharmaceutical companies, world pharmaceutical companies. It's a conspiracy that has been done by technological companies, those in the banking sector, okay? They have arrived at this so that they can make profit. This is a conspiracy by people with demonic agendas, those who control the world. Okay, They have arrived at this. This is a conspiracy by those who are controlling the world education sector. They don't want universities to enroll people physically to gather. They want universities to be accessing lessons online. Okay? This is a conspiracy by those that want to control the population of the world. The population of the world, we are close to 6 billion, over 6 billion people. But from the time that this COVID-19 started, how many people have died? I can assure you that the population of the world has shaken because of the coronavirus. The last part of my presentation, I want to say that there are countries in the world that have got the agenda of weakening economies of other countries. They are using the coronavirus to weaken economies of other countries. If India is the fastest growing economy in the world, chasing after China, they will put coronavirus in India in order to weaken the economy of India. Because when there is coronavirus in India, the Indian government will be forced, okay, to buy ventilators, to allocate more budget and more money in curing and combating the virus, thereby weakening their treasury, their national treasury. And the reason why this will happen, and the reason why people who have got a vested interest in weakening the economies of other countries is because they want to be the superpower themselves. They want to be the only superpower. The economy of India, as we are speaking right now, has weakened because of the coronavirus that is in India. What has happened to the economy of China? What has happened to the economy of the United States, the economy of Russia? You must open your eyes, Africa. You must see this, that the coronavirus is also being used to weaken currencies of different countries that are perceived to be performing well. I also want to say that the coronavirus is being used to weaken countries that are stubborn to accept certain policies, to accept certain agreements. Okay, if we in Zambia, we have refused to accept a certain a foreign policy or international treaty, or we have refused to accept something that is being championed by world corporations or a certain government, they will put coronavirus in our country so that they weaken our economy. Okay? So, the issue of the coronavirus is being used by politicians to ascend to power. Politicians are also using coronavirus. When they want to help a particular politician to get power, they use coronavirus. When they want to use the coronavirus to bring down a certain politician, they will use coronavirus. Coronavirus is the greatest world conspiracy that is happening in the world. I know that after speaking this video, Facebook will not be happy. But I have to speak this so that tomorrow when I die, tomorrow when my Facebook page has been deactivated, just know that I spoke the truth about coronavirus. There are a lot of people whose Facebook pages, there are a lot of doctors whose Facebook pages, YouTube channels have been shut down because of speaking the truth about coronavirus. It is one decision that I've decided to follow and to accept, because these people, they control the media, they control TV stations, they control Facebook, they control YouTube, they control Amazon, they control Zoom, WhatsApp. They are controlling the world. And anybody who tries to speak against the coronavirus is dealt with. Presidents that have spoken against coronavirus, it's either they are dead, or their platforms, their media platforms have been shut down. They control the world. They want to control the world population. They want to make money. They want to bring the world. It is a new world order. What they are calling the new normal, it is a new world order where they want to bring the world in one basket. This we must be very careful about. It will take men and women who are God-fearing to pray about it. It will take men and women who understand where Africa is coming from. We as Africans are great people. All civilizations, they come from Africa. Africa is the beginning of mathematics. It is the end of biology. The Greek people, the Romans, they attacked and invaded Egypt for them to get mathematical formulas. They attacked and invaded Egypt for them to get civilizations on science. Okay? They got and attacked and enslaved our people. They got Egyptians. They got Africans and took them to Europe in slavery to go and learn how to build buildings that can last a test of time. They got our African men to go and build France, to go and build America, to go and build Britain. They did that. That is what they did. They got our brothers and sisters in Egypt to go and enslave them so that they can learn how to make Panado, so that they can learn how to make drugs. We as Africans are a great continent. We are a great nation. We were one people before we were divided into countries. We are one people. If we fail to find the cure of COVID-19, of COVID Delta, it means we are children of a lesser God. If we fail to find the cure, our own cure of COVID-19, it means that we are a race that is inferior. I refuse to accept that Africa is a continent of Dao people. We are a great continent. Madagascar pulled out of the World Health Organization because they came up with their own COVID cure and they were suspended. They were attacked by the World Health Organization. Today, the World Health Organization have come up with AstraZeneca. They have come up with a COVID vaccine that has not helped to cure COVID-19 in Africa. That is when we have seen more people die in Africa. That is when we have seen more people die around the world. More people die in India. More people die in Mexico. More people die in Russia. Even after we have come up with a COVID-19 vaccine. This is the greatest world conspiracy that shall forever be told for many years and many, many years to come by our great-great-grandchildren. We will not be there. But I want to speak for the future generations that in our generation today, there has been a virus that has been created. And this virus continues to be moved from one stage to the other. From one wave to the other, depending on whether they have achieved their mission or not. We cannot have a virus that comes like a movie, that comes like a movie series, that comes like a movie series. We can't have a wave, first wave, second wave, third wave. Now we have got fourth wave called COVID Delta. We cannot have this type of a virus. When malaria came on the face of the world, we did not have first wave of malaria, second wave of malaria, third wave of we never had a type of malaria that had seasons, waves, types, paths. Malaria came once and we found the cure to malaria. The same people that are behind the HIV and AIDS pandemic are the same people that are behind the manufacturing in the lab of COVID-19. The same people that manufactured the swine flu that wiped millions of people 100 years ago is the same people that are behind the manufacturing of this deadly pandemic. Okay? You have to share this broadcast and let the world know that Africa has risen. Africa has woken up. We have realized the truth. And the truth is that this pandemic that they keep bringing in parts, first wave, second wave, fifth wave, we are now going to 20 wave. It is a conspiracy. And those that seek to speak about it are shut down. They are killed using slow poison. Their Facebook pages are shut down. They are silenced. Don't be surprised if this Facebook page is shut down. Don't be surprised if you see some of us dead. Just know that we have spoken the truth. Okay? This video will stand a test of testimony for many years to come, because I would have spoken the truth for the future generations. In closing, I want to warn the entire world and the entire Africa that this group of people that are in the system of creating vaccines and pandemics has been in existence for many years, over 100 years. They have got an institute that has been in existence, and they continue recruiting more students in creating vaccines and pandemics. The world, Africa, is yet to see more pandemics, deadly pandemics, than the coronavirus. Because pandemics are one way that they use to control the economies of the world. Pandemics are one way that they use to control the population of the world. Pandemics are one way that they use to control, to unite one world together. They used this pandemic in 2000. They used this pandemic in the 90s. They are going to use this pandemic to change the trajectory of the world into coming up with one world order. They want to use the pandemic to have one currency. They want to use a pandemic to do away with the order of things. The reason why it's called the New World Order is because they want to have a cashless society where we will not be using cash, money, paper money. They want to use digital platforms. This money that we are using will be the thing of the past. After the pandemic, after they have achieved their mission, this money that we are using, you will no longer see this money. Money will be moving in mobile phones. Money will be moving digitally. These pandemics, you shall no longer see universities. You will no longer see students going to sit on desks to go and learn. Students will be in their homes learning through online platforms like Zoom, Skype, WhatsApp, YouTube. When this agenda is done, people will be doing their shoppings online. When this pandemic is done, politicians and governments will be controlled by this pandemic. The richest people will be technological companies, pharmaceutical companies who have the monopoly of drugs. They want to use drugs to control the world. They want to control the world to be in one world. Share this broadcast and let the world know that Africa has risen. We have come to realize the truth. And in the course to speak this truth, I know that even my fellow countrymen and women, Zambians, who oppose me, but I don't care. I don't care, because we have got the right, fundamental human right, to express ourselves. And this thing that I'm speaking is nothing else but an expression of myself. I'm enjoying my fundamental human rights. Share this broadcast and let the world know that this coronavirus, for me, is a greatest conspiracy. And speaking about it, I'm ready to face all consequences. I really thank you for following this broadcast.